Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Vladimir Vukovic. I'm a lecturer in urban design at the Carinthia University of Applied Science. And I'm going to say you a few words about urban planning inputs as an additional information on the project RenoPass 2014. At the Carinthia University of Applied Science, RenoPass is a part of two other projects in urban planning and in architectural design. This means that our students are continuing working on this project also in the time after our common workshop in Carinthia. We wanted to share this part of the planning inputs with all of you because perhaps it could be useful for the process of finding ideas for the project tasks of the RenoPass. To begin with the planning site. The planning site is the former military area Heereszeugsanstalt in the city of Klagenfurt with about 6,000 square meters. It's near to the city center, only 200 meters to the city ring road. You can see the red one, named Ringstrasse. Let's have a look at this air photograph. There is the city ring, the yellow line, and the other one, the other yellow line, is Feldkirchner Straße, leading in front of our planning area. You can see the red circle. In the neighborhood of our planning area, you can see on this photograph, there are two buildings. There are sports halls, indoor sports halls, and you can see left and right, on the left and right side, the sports courts. Today we have four existing buildings in the planning area. These buildings were a part of the supply department of the Austrian Army in German Heereszeugsanstalt. For example, in the past there were a bakery, today named Hauptgebäude, a bed storage building, today Lagergebäude, a fruit storage, today Lager- und Garagengebäude, and the old storage building, Haferdepot. In the main building, Hauptgebäude, there were also living rooms and offices. Today these buildings haven't been used by the army for many years. Now let's move on to history. We still don't have complete historical data about these buildings, but I'm going to show you the documents we have found until now. First of all, they are the documents from the Austrian State Archive. That was a very complicated process to find these documents. War Archive, or the Austrian Military Archive, is a part of the Austrian State Archive, and you can see the list of the documents we had to watch to until we find the right one. For example, this is the list of the year about 1900. This is the list of the building department of the 6th Brigade of the Austrian Army, and you can see all existing buildings in our planning area at that time. Today some of these buildings don't exist anymore. Here is a site plan, one of the oldest site plans of the plan of our planning area. We find it undated, but you can see, first of all, in our planning area there are much more buildings than today, and below of our planning area there was a part named Zeugsanstalt. It was a part of the supply department. Today this part of the area doesn't exist anymore. Here is the site plan of the year 1924 and the site plan of the year 1933. This is the part of the site plan 1933 with our planning area. Some of these buildings don't exist anymore today. For example, the residential building showed in the plan below and two storage buildings on the top left. It was the hay and straw storage building, and on the top right it was the solid fuel storage. In the middle of the area you can see the firefighting facility, Feuerlöschdepot. And you can see also some smaller additional buildings which don't exist anymore today. Two of the removed buildings on the site were built as wooden barracks, below and on the top. And the right, on the right hand side you can see Zeugslager. It's the part of this military supply area which don't exist anymore today. Today there is a new building of the district court of Klagenfurt with the car park. In front you can see the main building of the area, the former residential building and with the bakery and offices. We have found in the archive the floor plans of these buildings from 1928. You can see the ground floor and the first floor and particularly basement floor plan. And this is another floor plan of the former residential and bakery building where we can see the grid of the columns. The next building is the former bed storage building, today only storage building, Lager. The floor plans of the former bed storage building. And the next one is the former fruit storage or food storage building, today only storage building and garage. You can see the ground floor plan and the attic floor. The former old storage building is the last building on the site completed after 1926. Here we can see the floor plans of the former old storage building, Haferdepot. And the last plan of the archive, there are floor plans of the buildings which don't exist anymore today. For example, on the top left, it's a residential building, Wohngebäude. In the middle, Feuerlöschdepot, firefighting facility. On the top right is a wash house or cleaning house. And right below we have still existing building of the Betten Depot bed storage building. And now there are the historical maps of the Austrian National Library. Here is one of the oldest city plans of Klagenfurt from the year 1709. In history we had in the area of today's Carinthia first the Celtic kingdom of Noricum and afterwards the province Noricum of the Roman Empire. After the migration period at the time of Charles the Great there was a Slavic principality within the Carolingian empire named Carantania. The foundation of Klagenfurt, city of Klagenfurt, was in the 12th century. The city wall you can see on this plan was built in the 16th century by Domenico dell'Aglio, an Italian architect from the Lombardy. At that time was also built the land canal, a water canal between the lake of Wörthersee and the water ditch of the city. You can see it on the left side. The function of this canal was the supply of water for the fire rescue for the city and the delivery of building and fuel materials for the city, for example wood or stone. In the past there was also a stream named Feuerbach, you can see it below, on the top, on the northern side of the city. This stream, Feuerbach, was a water supply for the city on the northern side and as wastewater of the city on the southern side. In 1809, Napoleon Bonaparte had the city wall turned down. He destroyed it. Just before the freedom contract of Schönbrunn between him and Francis II. Francis II was the last emperor of the Holy Roman Empire and the first Austrian Empire, there's the Kaiser. Actually, this demolition of the city wall, this act enabled the expansion of the city of Klagenfurt. Today, in the location of the former city wall and the castle moat, there is the big green belt around the city of Klagenfurt. This is where our planning area is today. And this is the city plan of the year 1863. Most of the buildings on our planning area were built between 1823 and 1826. By the way, a part of Carinthia belonged for a time to the administration district of Graz, Gubernium Graz, between 1782 and 1825, and between 1825 and 1848 to the administration district of Laibach, Gubernium Laibach. In 1849, Carinthia became independent again. You can see our planning area in the year 1863. There is still no old storage building at that time. And here we have the city plan of the year 1926. You can see the expansion of the city. And our planning area, there is still no old storage building. It must be built after 1926. The city plan of Klagenfurt today. Today, Klagenfurt is the capital of Carinthia and the biggest city of Carinthia with nearly 100,000 inhabitants. Our planning area today, you can see this master plan. We got a copy of an urban design project of the year 2008 from the Spado architects from Klagenfurt. And this is the site plan of the existing buildings. A photograph of the model. I would like you to look at these AutoCAD drawings of the existing buildings, which we already have in our project files. First of all, that's the residential building, the former bakery. The first floor and the second floor. The cross section and the particular basement. The bed storage building, ground floor and the attic plan. The old storage building, a typical floor plan, cross section and longitudinal section. The fruit and food storage building, the ground floor plan and the cross section. All these files are stored in the Dropbox. You have the link to the Dropbox below. And you can find there the following folders: archive, historical maps, literature list, plans, and the last two folders, schedule and tasks, concerning only the students from Austria. In the folder of archive, you can find all the maps, all the historical maps I showed you. In the folder of historical maps, you can find all historical site plans of our planning area you saw it, and the list of literature is separated in four parts. The first one is literature concerning the city of Klagenfurt, literature concerning urban regeneration and brownfield, literature in general concerning urbanism and cities. Some of the books are in German, some in English, and some books I gave you both editions in German and in English. And the last part are the maps, the list of the historical maps from the Austrian National Library. And the last folder with the AutoCAD drawings, AutoCAD plans of the existing buildings. For more details, don't hesitate to contact us, and I'm looking forward to seeing you in Carinthia in April at our workshop week. Thank you very much and goodbye.